What do you call a master jazz musician who played brilliant alto and tenor sax, recorded over 100 albums in 40 years, helped define bebop and hard bop, while also known for his sweet ballads, toured constantly, and played with almost every jazz legend throughout his career? Well, you'd call him Sonny. Sonny Stitt, that is. Born in Boston in 1924, Edward Hammond Boatner Jr. was destined to be a musician. While he was born into a musical family, he was adopted at a young age by the Stitt family in Saginaw, Michigan. But music was in his blood, and by his early 20s, Sonny Stitt was already jamming alongside tenor genius Stan Getz. He was a featured player in Tiny Bradshaw's big band as well. By 1945, he had a stint in Billy Eckstine's big band, where he met both Dexter Gordon and a man he would record many albums with, tenor player Gene Ammons. He was one of the most proficiently recorded jazz artists ever. Early on in his alto playing days, Stitt was criticized for sounding too much like the legendary Charlie Parker. When Parker got to hear Stitt, he remarked, "Well, I'll be damned, you sound just like me." To which Sonny replied, "Well, I can't help the way I sound, it's the only way I know how to play." He must not have minded the comparisons too much, as he eventually recorded an album called Stitt Plays Bird. Even though that criticism stuck while he played alto sax, his tenor playing was pure Stitt. His recordings with great bop artists like Bud Powell, Dizzy Gillespie, Art Pepper, and Sonny Rollins are considered classics. Stitt didn't let bop define his style. In the late 1950s, he dipped into Afro-Cuban jazz, recording Latin arrangements of jazz standards with the likes of Thad Jones and Chick Corea. In 1960, Stitt briefly played in Miles Davis's band, but was replaced by Hank Mobley, as Miles fired him because of a drinking problem Sonny developed after kicking heroin. His recordings with fellow tenor player Gene Ammons are regarded as some of the best dueling partnerships in jazz history. Sonny also recorded soul jazz early on. His 1964 recording of Soul People with Booker Irvin is considered one of the pioneers in that genre of jazz. He is also regarded as one of the first jazz sax players to record using the Selmer Veritone amplified saxophone. Sonny Stitt was a complicated musician. While never truly embraced by the public, he was respected by his peers and critics. Nicknamed the Lone Wolf, he never seemed to rest, always recording and releasing new music, either as a leader or side player, constantly touring and living the jazz life. That life was not an easy one for Sonny. He passed away in 1982 at 58 years old.